Dear colleagues, board members, and friends, I am Sandra Yerso Torres, current ICM Vice President. This is the board briefer for the board meeting on Wednesday, 25th of May. During this meeting, we reviewed the updated procurement and conflict of interest policies. We unanimously approved these policies, which will allow us to move forward and further strengthen ICM and each of the decisions we make. We approved the first quarter financial report of ICM, considering the challenges we continue to face due to the COVID pandemic. Our financial situation is stable and healthy. We will move forward into the second quarter keeping alert, thanks to the support of the Board Finance Audit and the Risk Committee and, of course, the Head Office Financial Team. We had an explorative brainstorm about the future of ICM's global triennial congresses. In an unstable world where we face pandemics, wars, and climate crisis, we need to explore what Congress's format would work best for our members, as well as the future of midwifery globally. We had different questions that we raised during the meeting. Should ICM Congresses be held triennially? Should our focus be on global or regional conferences? Should Congresses have another frequency? What are the disadvantages of online, hybrid, and face-to-face congresses? We will continue this discussion after some concepts and further development by the head office team. Finally, we would like to end this briefer with a piece of news that we are very happy to share. We have accepted two new midwives associations as members of ICM. First of all, the Saudi Association of Midwives, Midwifery, and secondly, the Association Civil de Parteras Profesionales de Guatemala, APPG. Welcome to our ICM family. Dear colleagues, greetings from each of us. Let's continue to be strong advocates for our profession of midwifery around the world for the sake of the women we serve.